So let's see this question. You have to find the current in the given network. So see children, now you have to just keep it in mind, like wherever you have got 4 or 5 circuits, 4 or 5 resistances, it can be most probably it will be a Wheatstone bridge. Now see that how will you, it doesn't look like Wheatstone bridge from any angle. So let's see how will you reduce it to Wheatstone bridge. Now you can say that we have got the battery of 4 volt, right? So now you know that the current will flow. So as the current will flow in this arm, so this is the current is flowing in this direction. Now you know that battery, this is the higher potential and this side is the lower potential, right? So that means this end A will be at my potential V, right? And this end C, lower potential, that means you can say that this is at zero potential. So A, you have found the potential V, A pe or C pe it's zero. Now let's see, now how will you proceed? Now you come to arm, you reached A, now you'll go in this direction. Now as the current will flow, that means the potential will change, right? So say that, let at this point you can say that my potential is X. Alright, potential will change, right? Now you'll come, again the current is flowing in this direction, right? So that means now the potential at this end is zero. Okay, now come to the resistance 5 ohm. Now here the potential is X. Again, that means the potential at this point, that means this point, my potential, say that this point is D. Okay, so at point D, my potential is, let's say the potential is Y. Okay, so have you understood? So this is my point A, right? And at this end, when I go from 1 ohm resistance, that means the potential at A is V, the same as at the battery. And as we flow, the potential changes. The current flows from higher potential to lower potential. Let's say that at this point, right, my potential is X. Let's say this point, I'm denoting it with B. So at my B, the potential is X. And as again, the current will divide. So the current will go through 2 ohm. The potential at here is X and the potential at this point is 0. Now you come to 5 ohm resistance. In the 5 ohm resistance, the potential at point is X. Again, the potential will fall. Say the potential at point D is Y. So you can see the potentials. How many potentials are there? V, X, Y and 0. Okay. So let's say that I can write this as my point V. And say I'll write my potential X and I can say my potential Y and I can say my potential 0. Now let's say how the resistances are arranged. So that means you can say that at A my potential is V. Now comes the 1 ohm resistance. 1 ohm is connected between V and X. Okay, so between V and X I have connected resistance 1 ohm. Fine. Now you come to 2 ohm. The 2 ohm is connected between V and Y. See that? Here the potential is V and here the potential is Y. So between V and Y, my second resistance is connected. What is the resistance? That resistance is 2 ohm. Alright. Now come to the resistance 5 ohm. The 5 ohm is connected between X and Y. Alright. So say that this is my resistance. It's 5 ohm. Between X and Y. Now come to resistance 2 ohm. This is connected between X and 0. Okay. So between X and 0, I have got one more resistance that is equal to 2 ohm. Now comes to resistance 4 ohm. This is connected between Y and 0. Okay. Fine. So can you see that? How my circuit, which not from any angle look like the Wheatstone bridge, it has reduced to Wheatstone bridge. Okay, so now we have done the Wheatstone bridge. Now you see, this is my P, this is my Q, this is my R and this is my S. So you can see that we have to check after making the Wheatstone bridge, we have to check whether the circuit is balanced or not. So you can see P by Q is 1 by 2. What is R by S? What is my S between the resistance between, this is my 4 ohm resistance. Okay. So what's my P by Q? my P by Q is equal to R by S. This is the condition for the Beachstone bridge to be balanced. Let's see whether a Beachstone bridge is balanced or not. So what's my P? 1. What's my Q? 2. What's my R? 2. And what's my S? 4. So as you can see, half is equal to half. That means my Wheatstone bridge is balanced. Now you can easily find the resistance. So what my resistance, as we have done in the previous lecture, what now no current is flowing in this. That means now my circuit will reduce to, this is 1 ohm and 2 ohm. They are in series because no current is here. So they will be in series. Then similarly, you can say that 2 ohm and 4 ohm. Okay. They will also be in series. So this is my point A and this is my point C. So what's my resistance? 3 ohm and 6 ohm. The 3 ohm and 6 ohm resistance are in parallel. So what's my total resistance? As you know, if the two resistance are in parallel, product by sum. So what is this? 1 plus 2, 3. 4 plus 2, 6. So 3 into 6 upon 3 plus 6. So what you will get? 18 by 9. That means my resistance is 2 ohm. Alright. Now we have to find the current. Alright. So what's my current? My current is equal to V by R. So what's my V? My V is 4 volt. It's volt. 4 volt. And the current resistance is 2 ohm. So my current is 2 ampere. So see children, how cleverly you have to reduce it to the Wheatstone bridge. Just the only knack is that you have to apply the potentials. As I'm doing it once again, just see, this is my high potential, so I make it V, and then this is low potential, 0. So this point is at 0. Now as the current flows, right, the potential will fall. So let it point B, my potential is X. Okay, so my X is the potential, right? Now as I'm going from B to D, the potential falls. So at D, my potential is Y. And here my potential is C. Then what I have done? I've started from A. Then at A, my potential is V. Then I have four points, V, X, Y and 0. V, X, Y and 0. Now you see that 1 ohm is put between V and X, so I put, then you go to 2 ohm resistance. 2 ohm resistance is placed between V and Y. V and Y is 2 ohm. Then come to 5 ohm. 5 ohm is placed between X and Y. Alright. And then this 2 ohm is placed between B and O. Sorry, X and O. And then this 4 ohm is placed between Y and 0. So it looks like my Wheatstone bridge, your circuit is, and then you're using the condition. As the Wheatstone bridge is balanced, you have checked that. If P by Q is equal to R by S, that means my Wheatstone bridge is balanced. That means no current will flow in the arm 5 ohm. Alright, then my circuit will look like this. That means the two resistances, since no current flows in, these two will be in series. These two will be in series and then both of them in parallel. So you'll get your current to be equal to 2 ampere.